Bratwurst, Spätzle, Sauerbraten, falsche Hase, Maultaschen, Himmel und Erd, Schweinshaxe. Let me be very German about this and give my honest opinion of traditional German dishes. They're often very filling, pretty meaty, and usually sit somewhere on the spectrum of beige to brown. German food often tastes good, but looks not so great. Let's see what this German foodie makes of my assessment.
Also ja, ich meine, ich arbeite ja auch als Foodfotograf und wenn man mal so einen Gulasch fotografieren muss, dann ist es schon immer eine kleine Herausforderung. Aber witzigerweise, fast alle verstehen unter diesen Gerichten Soul Food. Also wenn du so, ne, so Essen, was ein gutes Gefühl vermittelt, was mit Erinnerungen verbunden ist, was irgendwie so wohlfühlen, dann ist es total oft der Braten, das Schnitzel. Dann ist es egal, wenn es nicht so schön ist. Das gibt halt ein gutes Gefühl.
Und wie würdest du traditionelles deutsches Essen beschreiben?
Ein deutsches Essen hat eine Sättigungsbeilage zu haben. Es gibt quasi nichts ohne eine Kartoffel, eine Nudel. Ganz klassisches Gericht aus meiner Kindheit, von meinen Großeltern, waren Nudeln und Bratkartoffeln. Carbs mit Carbs mit Carbs.
Und was kochst du für uns gleich?
Ich koche heute für uns Schnitzel, weil das ist halt wirklich, also gerade auch so, wenn ich an meine Kindheit und das Aufwachsen denke, so dieses typischste deutsche Gericht, was es bei uns total oft gab.
Of course, the schnitzel came to Germany via Austria. Germany is bordered by 9 different countries, and you can see the influence of those neighbors on regional cuisine near the borders. As well as regional differences, there's a seasonal aspect too. Many Germans get very excited about particular seasonal foods, such as asparagus, strawberries, cherries, or kale. Grünkohl essen is a special occasion when people get together to eat the leafy green usually served with cured sausage. Does barbecuing count as a seasonal speciality? In any case, as soon as the first rays of sun appear in late spring, the Germans are ready to grill. The first barbecue of the year is known as Angrillen, and in one study, a decisive 97% of Germans said they like to grill. Some key components at a German barbecue: lots of meat, potato salad, mustard, and little bread rolls that are completely impractical for putting sausages in. Talking of bread, it's obviously a huge part of the food culture here. So important, in fact, I already made a whole episode about it. Do check that out. But what else do we know about German tastes? The nation's favorite meat is pork. Around 5% of the population is vegetarian and 1% vegan. The top-rated vegetables are tomatoes, carrots, onions, and cucumber. Favorite fruits are bananas, apples, oranges, and melons. The country also has a deep relationship with potatoes in every form. Kartoffel is even a somewhat derogatory term for someone who is very German. Finally, some herbs and spices you might spot regularly in German recipes: parsley, dill, or in some regions, caraway seeds. Okay, now we've really worked up an appetite. Take it away, Sascha!
Dann haben wir hier unsere klassische Panierstraße. Erst ins Mehl, dann nächste Runde ist einmal in das geschlagene Ei. Und dann kommt es in die Panade. Wir haben jetzt hier eine Mischung aus so Flakes und Panko, was wiederum witzig ist, weil Panko ist eigentlich ein japanisches Paniermehl. Und ich denke, das ist eine schöne Möglichkeit, so diese urdeutschen oder urklassischen Gerichte so ein bisschen zu modernisieren. Das kommt jetzt so für 2 Minuten von jeder Seite bei einer mittleren Hitze. Auf gar keinen Fall zu heiß, sodass es schön sprudelt beim Anbraten. Schnitzel und Kartoffel geht halt Hand in Hand. Ob das jetzt Bratkartoffeln, Pommes, Salzkartoffeln sind, da hat man die freie Wahl. Und fertig ist unser Schnitzel.
To express that you hope someone enjoys their meal, you can say guten Appetit or more casually guten Hunger. But if you're feeling particularly German, why not throw Mahlzeit into the mix? It literally means mealtime, but particularly around lunchtime, it's a perfectly acceptable greeting. The appropriate response is Mahlzeit.
Mahlzeit.
Mahlzeit. Lecker. Talking of mealtimes, at breakfast, the Germans are generally split into 2 camps. Bread with cold cuts, egg, cheese, or sweet spreads, or some kind of muesli cereal or porridge. The main warm meal of the day is traditionally taken at lunchtime. Having grown up eating cold lunches, usually sandwiches, I still can't adjust to this, especially because it can take quite a while to recover from an enormous portion of hot German grub in the work canteen. Oh, and lots of Germans have lunch really early. I have colleagues who go to lunch before midday. The evening meal could be as simple as Abendbrot or evening bread, which, to be honest, is kind of like having breakfast all over again. But habits are changing, and around 1/3 of Germans now eat their main warm meal in the evening. According to a recent report, 3/4 of Germans enjoy cooking. When they're not in lockdown, around 1/2 eat out at least once a month, and 1/4 eat fast food once a week. The international cuisine on offer in Germany is telling of the country's immigration history. A small shop or stand offering speedy takeout food is called an Imbiss, which comes from the Old German for meal. But what about about in-between meals? The most popular snacks in Germany are chocolate and crisps. I can't for the life of me understand the nation's obsession with paprika flavour. But hey, each to their own. Okay, what's for dessert? I was a little disappointed to find that this course doesn't seem to get that much attention here. But cake lovers, fear not. There's always Kaffee und Kuchen, coffee and cake to look forward to. This traditional German pastime, which dates back to the 17th century, is something you typically do with your parents or your grandparents in the afternoon. For the full experience, crack out the fancy coffee cups and cake forks. Some classic German cakes include Schwarzwälder Kirschtorte, or Black Forest Gatto, Bienenstich, which means bee sting, and Marmorkuchen, marble cake. Tell me your German food likes and dislikes below, and look out for more German food delights over on Instagram, DW_meetthegermans.